According to Sue Podal at DDD, a lot of people make the mistake of arguing about the fairness of a rule instead of proving that the rule was applied incorrectly.
I think that's a very common mistake. The purpose of an administrative hearing is to object to our decision because we did not apply the rules as written.
If your dispute is not resolved during the pre-hearing period, the actual hearing takes place within 90 days of your request. Typically, it is held in a building like this one, but depending on where you live, it might even take place over the phone. At the start of the hearing, you turn your documents over to the judge and they are marked as evidence. Usually, the fair hearing coordinator goes first. You can ask him or her questions as well as any witnesses they might bring in to testify. Next, you get to tell your side of the story. This is your chance to explain exactly what you believe happened and in what way DDD did not follow the rules when making their decision. You ask questions of your witnesses if you have any. When you're finished, the judge and fair hearing coordinator can ask you and your witnesses questions. The administrative law judge issues a decision in writing within 90 days of your original request for a hearing. In their first appeal, Michael's family was successful even without having to go through an actual hearing. But as you'll see, they had a different experience with their next appeal.
My second appeal really had to do with a request to have a swing set replaced. Once again, Michael has autism, and one of the side effects is he gets overstimulus throughout the day. Could be the daylight, the noise, or whatever. To manage this stimuli, what he does is either swings or he gets on a trampoline in the evenings. This kind of calms him down. Well, what happened was Michael has physically outgrown his swing, so I put in a request asking DDD to pay to replace the swing set. The request was denied by DDD, the state. So the next process, as before, was to submit a request for an appeal to the Olympia office of DDD. I laid out my case, the state laid out their case. The judge gave some very encouraging signs to me that he was very sympathetic, he understood my argument. But a couple of weeks went by, surprisingly, and I got my denial from the state saying that they had, in essence, denied my appeal.
Michael's father reviewed for himself what went wrong and came to an important conclusion.
I argued it was appropriate, it was for Michael's needs, it was a medical necessity for Michael's needs, but I didn't have a law or rule to support that.
Michael's father is not discouraged by the judge's ruling or by having followed the appeal process.
The key is to be diligent in the process. If you don't do it, no one will.
As we've seen with Michael's family, the lesson is make the most of the process. It's your right to file an appeal when you feel the wrong decision was made about your services. If you ever do end up in a room like this one, telling your story to a judge, just remember to be patient and persevere because you are worth it.
This is an important story, Emily. A lot of families and individuals have to go through this kind of process, and I'm sure it can be intimidating.
Absolutely, but it's important to remember this process ensures that the rules are followed and everyone is treated fairly.
Now, if Michael's family had disagreed with the judge's decision, could they have taken the issue further?
Absolutely, Ed. It's important to know that every decision made, whether it's by the division, the administrative law judge, or the Board of Appeals, comes with written instructions for the next step in the appeal process.
Great story, Emily. If any of our viewers ever decide to request a fair hearing, you've given them good information for putting the process to work. That's it for this special edition of DDTV, your source for information on issues that affect your life. Thanks for joining us, and we hope that you tune in again next time.